nanoHUB-U, online instruction.
Hey everyone, welcome to lecture 121. So last time we were actually talking about how to maximize band gaps for diamonds and other types of 3D photonic crystal structures. And now we'll actually talk about something slightly different but related, which is how to find point defects using MPB. And so now we actually are going to define what's called a superlattice, in which we take our initial periodic structure and then we repeat it multiple times in the same computational cell. And the rationale for doing that is so then we can have like a single defect that would still preserve the overall behavior of that lattice. But of course, like because it's still periodic, then whatever defect we introduce could interact with its mirror image, which is repeated periodically. But then as you make larger and larger supercells, then we won't have as much of a problem. And so in this case, we're actually going to choose to use a supercell of 5x5. Otherwise, it's fairly similar to before we defined this cylinder, but we actually need 25 of these cylinders. So rather than actually explicitly defining all 25, we use what's called the geometric objects lattice duplicates thing, which can reproduce like a 5x5 in both direction over the full geometry of 5x5. Okay, and so this like will match all the lattice points like at distances that are integer multiples of the initial position. And then we can actually append a geometry of a single air cylinder. And then this will basically punch a hole right in the middle of our 5x5 supercell. And so this is creating the defect. And so then we can actually design like a K point. We only need a single K point. And then we can choose a very large number of bands because many of the bands are going to be folded over because it's 5x5, so we probably need at least 50 bands or so. And then we can actually expect that the 25th state, since it's a 5x5 superlattice, will be our defect, and we actually want to output the E field specifically for that defect. And then we also want to figure out how much energy is associated with that, so then we basically compute the energy in the object using this defined function, and then it's going to turn out that actually 2/3 of the energy almost is going to be contained within this air defect cylinder for the defect mode. And then we can actually do the calculation for the single band that we want as well if we use the targeted eigensolver, and we set the target frequency as kind of halfway between the top of the lower band and then the bottom of the upper band. And we set a very tight tolerance, then we can actually find the frequency is about 3.78. So it's actually much closer to the top than the bottom, but you can adjust it by changing the nature of the defect, of course. And then we can actually tune the point defect mode, like I was saying, by basically changing the epsilon. And so you can actually see that if epsilon is 1, then you can get that the frequency is going to look like this. If epsilon is 12, it's much lower, which kind of makes sense because it's in a, when it's in a higher dielectric material, that lowers the energy cost of staying in that region, which is confined. And then, of course, for intermediate epsilons, you also get intermediate frequencies. And so you can actually very explicitly target a certain frequency as well if you need to, which is kind of an interesting capability in its own right. And so in the next lecture, we'll kind of get close to concluding on the MPB and then start thinking about like what are some future steps.